What am I cooking today? In the crock pot, I put a quarter of that pork shoulder that I bought in that last grocery haul. I cooked it in the crock pot. Now it's pulled pork, and I have some hamburger buns, so I wanted a pulled pork barbecue sandwich. Do I have any barbecue sauce? No. I am making my own barbecue sauce. I've already added some to the pork in the crock pot. I'm just cooking this down a little bit more so it'll thicken. And then we can also dunk our sandwiches in that or put some more on our sandwich if we want more. So we're having barbecue sandwiches for dinner. All right, what do you think?
I love it. I don't know if I've ever had pulled pork brisket sandwich. Is that what you called it?
Yeah.
Just the meat by itself is great. And the combination with a toasted bun. So I was going to try a little
bit. Some with cheese.
Yeah, but it doesn't need it. I'm just going to try it to see because you suggested it.
Some people like it with cheese, some people don't.
I like it both ways equally. It's so good.
And I was going to have a sandwich, but I fixed hers first and then just kept fixing it as an open face. So, and can put a little bit more barbecue sauce, homemade barbecue sauce. There's some lettuce, jalapenos, pickles.
I'm so happy.
Let's eat. So, what am I making today? Pizza dough. So, homemade pizza dough, homemade pizza sauce. I'll link a description to the video below, but it's time to spread it out. That's a little bit too much flour, so anyway, that's what I'm doing this afternoon. It's kind of cold and rainy, so I got my oven on. So that's nice and warming. So let's make this pizza, and I'll show it to you when I get back. When I get back, I'm not going anywhere. I'll show it to you when it comes out of the oven, and maybe before. But I'm gonna get rid of some of this flour. Okay, I'm gonna put it in the oven for just a little bit. I find that when I don't do that, the bottom gets too dark too soon, and it's still a little doughy. It's in an RV oven, but so I'm gonna cook it for a little bit. Another trick that I have is a pizza stone, and that kind of helps even out the heat in the oven so you don't get the flame right on the pans or whatever you're cooking. I forgot to poke holes in it. It's puffing up. Poke some holes in it. Put it back in there for a minute or two. Not very long because it's getting there. There it is. Let's look at the bottom. Yeah, that looks good. Didn't burn.
Yeah.
I think I'm going to put that back in there for a minute. So I put it back in the oven, but I put it on the bottom. So the flame is actually, it's like a broiler. And so it got a little toasty on top. Toasted the cheese a little bit. I like it. Okay, I want to show you one of my frugal finds. I've been finding pork chops here in New Mexico. a lot cheaper, or pretty cheap on sale. So this is, I don't know, 6-7 pork chops. I don't know until I open it. $6.02. It's $2.39 a pound. And so that's about $1 a pork chop. That's what I'm going to kick in the air fryer tonight. That is so good. So tender. So moist. Look at that. Took about 6 minutes on one side, and then I did 6 minutes on the other. And it's not overcooked. I did check it with my handy dandy thermometer. So, that is so good. Okay, we're eating. I added a little bit of fried okra, which I did not do in the air fryer because I had the air fryer busy. I went ahead and cooked all 6 of those pork chops. Did I tell you how much those pork chops cost?
You just told me, and my mind is blown.
Yeah. So it was $6 for the whole package. $6.02, so.
So this scrumptious,
huge
pork chop
was $1.
Was $1.
Yeah.
And it's heavenly.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Yeah. And that okra is fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's eat.
Perfectly seasoned.
Hmm. Tammy sees the deer. Bandit don't see the deer. You're fixing to lose your winter coat, aren't you?